morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday. Welcome back to science class. It's good to see you all. So up first, I want to discuss a couple changes that I'm going to be making to our online science class here. So over the past couple of weeks, we've sort of had a set schedule of every single day, I post a new assignment. That assignment comes with a video in which I go over the expectations. I walk through it with you. Then you work on that, submit it, and then come back the next day for something new. That's worked fairly well so far, but we are going to be making a change to hopefully sort of streamline this process a little bit. Going forward, we're going to be, instead of doing daily activities like I've been doing, I'm going to be moving more toward doing weekly activities, where on Monday, or in this case Tuesday, I post something that's a little bit longer, but it's meant to be worked on throughout the entire week. Okay, so that way you're not sort of always coming back every single day with a new task, but instead you're getting it more upfront, then you have some extended time to work on that. There's a few reasons for that change. Some of those reasons are, in terms of as a grade, we're going to be moving more toward a more scheduled approach. As sort of these days go on and we go deeper and deeper into our content, I think it's going to be easier if we sort of get on a schedule of what you should be working on each day. So having this information out at the beginning of the week kind of helps you plan a little bit more and manage your time. It also allows us to sort of go a little bit deeper into the content. Instead of breaking it up into all these parts, you can sort of have a bigger activity that sort of goes into more detail that you can then sort of access at your own level. And then three, for myself, it's going to kind of help me out. I've really enjoyed making these daily videos, and I'm still going to be making YouTube videos, don't worry. But I want to have a little bit more freedom and a little bit more time to try out some different styles of videos, some different pieces of content. Just to be honest, making these videos every day takes a lot of time. So instead of doing one every day where I have to edit it every single day, film it every day, I'm going to move toward doing one of these videos per week where I talk about the assignments for the entire week. Then that should allow me to have a little bit more time to be able to put out other videos, more informational videos or more creative things to sort of talk about the science and talk about the content that we're discussing. So those are some of the reasons for this change. But with that being said, the assignment that I'm posting today is meant to be worked on for the entirety of this week. We're going to be doing a little bit of a web quest. When we started all of this, I told you that the purpose of it was for us to better understand COVID-19, or the coronavirus as it's commonly called, to understand how it actually works and how it affects us. The first step was understanding us as humans, understanding our building blocks, which is the cell. The past 2 weeks was going into all the organelles and understanding how they work. That's super important because the coronavirus and viruses in general attack our cells. They use our cells. So we need to understand that first. Now that we've built that understanding, starting this week, we're going to be taking a look at actual viruses, what they are made of, how they replicate, how they spread, what kind of types there are. And things like that, including the coronavirus. So today's activity, this week's I should say, is all about viruses. All about viruses and how they work and things like that. So I'm going to be walking through it with you. Again, this is a week-long assignment, not a day-long assignment. So it may seem a little bit longer. This video is also going to be very long. But don't let that discourage you, okay? Because this is meant to be worked on over the course of multiple days. All right, so let's get into it. Okay, so here we have the assignment right here. This can be found on the classwork tab of your classroom page under today. Now, like I said, this is going to be a week-long assignment instead of a single day assignment. Okay, so keep that in mind when we're looking at how long it is that this is meant to span multiple days instead of just one. It's also going to remain in that today tab for the entirety of the week, just because at any point that you pull up the classroom page, that's where you're going to find it, and it will be the active task for you to do. Okay, so it's built as a web quest here. So embedded in this document is going to be a number of different links that you're going to use to complete tasks and answer questions. Okay, so I'm going to walk you through this right now. It's about 4 pages, but again, this is meant to be worked on over the course of a week. This doesn't need to be done in one sitting.
Okay, so to get started up here at the top, there is a link that when you click it, it's going to bring you to the Arizona State University page where they discuss viruses and viral attacks. This has some good information here about different ways you can catch it, their structure, and things like that. Some very helpful things. Keep this picture in mind. This is going to be important in a second. And some real life photos through microscopes and things like that. Okay, this is going to be important because the question associated with this first link is what does a virus look like and what are the three typical parts that we find in a virus? So you see this picture here and it has three lines attached. This middle yellow stuff inside goes to here. You'll have to go over where I put type and sort of backspace and then type it there. The formatting is a little bit weird, but I trust you can figure it out. Number two points to these little purple dots, so you'll type it here over this. And then number three points to this outer like purple layer here, so you will like type here to overwrite that and put your answers there. And that's from that link there. Moving on to number two, taking a look at the size of a virus. How does it stack up to with things we interact in the real world? So when you click this link here, it takes us back to a familiar website. This has been a wonderful website for animations and models. I've enjoyed using it. So you're going to click Start Animation, and I'm just going to turn the sound off here. And what we're going to find is we have a little animation here, and you can sort of zoom into the head of this nail, and as you do it, it kind of shows us the scale of how different microscopic things relate to each other. Okay, and the further you zoom in, the more that you see. And there's some different examples here that you can sort of click to sort of see how they stack up inside of the model. Okay, so you can sort of investigate that. And the question we're answering here is how big is a rhinovirus? So we're going to be looking at, you're going to use these steps here on that website to answer that question. Now, task number three brings us to a YouTube video.
Other cell.
Now, this video is going to be very important. This is also put out by the Amoeba Sisters. We checked out one of their videos a few days ago, and their information is really very excellent. I really enjoy their videos. They're easy to sort of understand. They're at a good pace. As always, I like the little animations. I'm a visual learner, so they help me out. So going through this video is going to help you out answer a good majority of this assignment. Okay, so there are a few things going after that video. You gotta tell me the cause of the common cold. You'll answer that here. Then it wants to know the three components of the modern cell theory. Now that's going to be right out of the video. There's a big graphic. When you get to that point, pause it and then type the three components into these boxes here. Okay, you can't miss it. It's right in the video. And then you're also going to use that video to answer the following questions here, all the way down through number 11. And there's a little model here of a virus structure. Now, moving into task number four, talks about the two different replication cycles for viruses, the lytic cycle and the lysogenic cycle. Both of these have models here that kind of go over the stages of a virus's replication and reproduction as it takes over cells. This sort of breaks it down in a visual sense, but both of these are also talked about inside of the virus video. So this video will also lend itself to answering all of these questions here. Okay, so you have two resources there. You have these models here, and then you can also use that video. So this video from task number three applies to much more. Okay, so these questions here will all be addressed by that. So use the video and those pictures to answer those questions, and then that continues all the way down into this third page here. All right. Next, we want to look at how viruses affect us. Viruses are affecting us quite a bit right now, but it's not the only way. The coronavirus that we're experiencing may be new, but viruses have been affecting us for as long as we can remember. And it's important to look at the other things that can sort of happen because of that. So for task number five, we're going to be looking at a common one. We're going to be looking at the common cold. We've all gotten colds at some point in our lives. So we want to take a look at sort of what we can do about it, why we feel the way we do during a cold, and how we can make it better. So the resource we're going to be using this is the CDC, or the Center for Disease Control. This is the actual government agency whose job it is to handle outbreaks, pandemics, and diseases and things like that. This is a great resource. We're going to be using their websites, where they talk about the cold, the symptoms, prevention, reducing spread and getting better and things like that. You're going to use all of this information to answer the questions about the common cold. Okay, this is good life advice and good tips to have, especially now that we're all a little bit more focused on germs and cleanliness and things like that. I also recommend just remembering the CDC, remembering this. This is a great source as we're all trying to keep up to date with what's going on with the coronavirus. So going to their main page, just front and center, they have up-to-date information. They're the ones in charge of handling this pandemic. So if you're looking for a place to get reliable information, this is the place to go. They are the ones actually keeping track. They have all the information on cases, spreading, which states have it worse, and things like that. This is a great place to look because these numbers are reliable and trustworthy. All right, so that's going to cover number 5. And then we're just going to be taking a look at a couple other viruses as well. Looking at respiratory syncytial virus. I think I said that correctly. Also by the CDC here, a few questions. The Humapara influenza virus here. Adenoviruses, and finally coronaviruses. The one word COVID-19 is a newer strain we're experiencing now, but coronaviruses have been around before, and their structures have been researched and things like that. So we're going to start now taking a look at the actual structure of them and to better understand how they affect us, why it's spreading so fast, and what we can do about it. Okay, so this final page here tackles another couple reactions to viruses, all with links used to answer the questions there.
Okay, guys, so that is this week's assignment. You're going to be working on that all this week. Like I said at the beginning of this video, instead of having multiple daily activities, we're going to be moving more toward week-long activities that you can sort of self-pace and work through it at your own free will there. So, as always with these assignments, multiple ways to contact me. You can leave a private comment right on here on this assignment, and I will reply to it as soon as I see it. You can also use the 6th grade frequently asked questions board. You can click the link on there to come to my page, and then on there you can kind of talk to me about it and ask any questions or anything like that. So that's how you can sort of get in contact with me there. Keep an eye out this week. I am still planning to do a Thursday Google Meets call. In the past, we've done them at 11. This week, probably aiming more for 12 o'clock just because I have a meeting that morning and things like that, and that's when I'll be readily available. The plan for that meeting as of right now is just talking more about these viruses, going over this work here. That could be a good place if you have questions, you can bring them there. And sort of discussing it like that, I'll probably do like a little informal lesson, and then we can sort of do maybe some review or something like that. We'll see. Still working on that. Keep an eye out for announcements on that going forward. I'll probably put the link up on the Google Classroom page on Thursday and with more directions and more information there. Okay, so with that being said, if you guys have a question, you know how to contact me. I hope you all have a wonderful week, and I'll talk with you soon.